So, my friends, today I have some interesting insights to share with you. And I'll start with the philosophy that came to us from the great philosopher Immanuel Kant. So I'm sure you've heard about Immanuel Kant, one of the most influential philosophers of all time, I would say, Western philosophers. Immanuel Kant was born in 1724 in Königsberg. At that time, it was part of Prussia. Now it's called Kaliningrad, and it's in Russia. Immanuel Kant lived and worked his entire life in Königsberg. He was professor of logic and metaphysics at the University of Königsberg. He's considered one of the most influential philosophers of all time. He's known for his works on epistemology, ethics, aesthetics, etc. He was single, never married, and lived a very, very simple life as well. Anyway, because of Immanuel Kant, we have these concepts called noumenon and phenomenon. Noumenon and phenomenon. So, noumenon and phenomenon in Kantian philosophy. Noumenon refers to the unknowable reality behind appearances, while phenomenon refers to our observable experience of that reality. This aligns with the wave function being a mathematical object representing the potential of a quantum system, in my view, while the particle is the actualized outcome upon observation. Noumenon and phenomena are inherently dualistic, with one being hidden and the other manifest. Similarly, wave and particle aspects of quantum entities may be seen as two sides of the same coin, accessible under different conditions. So, does the wave function correspond to the noumenon? And does the particle at a quantum level represents phenomenon? So, as you know, there are many, many theories right now on the interpretation of quantum mechanics. And I have been thinking about this a lot. I'm not a mathematician, but to me, the wave function is the infinite potential for manifestation. The particle is the actual perceived phenomenon as the manifestation of the invisible potential. So what we call a particle is actually a snapshot of an actuality. So the snapshot is the actual experience, but even the snapshot is gone even as it appears. So in my thinking, we are the noumenon and not the phenomenon. Noumenon. So let's actually think of this a little more, because before a wave function collapses, it's a cloud of probabilities. And before it's a cloud of probabilities, it's a field of infinite possibilities. And it's borderless, infinite, irreducible, and fundamental. That is the ultimate noumenon. Not even the wave function. Of course, Schrodinger, who described the wave function, likened it to Atman, the self of the individual, which is also the self of the universe. Kant says that the noumenon is unknowable. And I agree that it's unknowable as an observed phenomenon, because it is in fact that which manifests as observed observation and the localized observer. Ultimate reality is non-local, infinite, borderless, irreducible, fundamental, divine. That's why it's called the unknowable. But we know it as our knowing of that which we know, and as our knowing of that which we don't know. What is it that knows knowing? That which knows knowing is traceable as the root of all experience in every species, in every knower, in every mode of knowing, in everything known. And that is the divine mind, or let's say divine consciousness, that is differentiating into innumerable modes of knowing and knowers and things known. So who are we as body mind? As body mind, we are the recycling of that knowing and the evolution of that knowing that takes on a personal identity. But that which we call the personal identity is not fixed. It's constantly recycling, evolving through eons of time. That personal identity is what the infinite impersonal, so-called unknowable, is modifying itself as infinite, I would say, infinite because it keeps recycling and evolving. Personal identities that in turn are recycling and evolving. So who's Deepak? Deepak is one of those personal identities recycling and evolving through eons of time. All sentient beings are that, and they are differentiated aspects of what we might call the divine Godhead. The divine Godhead is the noumenon, and its manifestations are infinite phenomena which become the observable in every snapshot of perception. So I would suggest that this is the divine interpretation of quantum mechanics. And of course, current science, based on purely objective phenomena without addressing the observer, even though the Copenhagen interpretation attempts to define the observer, or at least the role of the observer in the collapse of the wave function. Ultimately, it's not the individual observer, because the individual observer is also in the realm of the manifest. Only the divine Godhead is actually responsible for all manifestations. In fact, the infinite manifestations that we define as the collapse of the wave function. So let's call this the divine theory of quantum mechanics. Let me know what you think. Of course, there are many others: transactional, future event horizon, weak measurements, multiverses, Copenhagen, on and on. Even those are conceived as possibilities or probabilities in the divine unknowable, which is knowable actually as the knower of all knowing. Let me know what you think. I somehow have great pleasure and enjoyment in sharing these ideas with you.